the Earth. It floats in space, bright and beautiful. An oasis in the darkness. A lovely blue and white orb set against a sea of stars. The Earth's striking beauty comes from the oceans that stretch across nearly three quarters of its surface. The seas affect everything on the planet: climate, weather, geological processes, and life. Humans stand on the shoreline where two worlds meet. Our ancestors may have come from the ocean, but we are creatures of the land. We can visit the ocean, swim in its lagoons, and ride across its surface, knowing that the birthplace of our most ancient predecessors lies beneath those restless waves. We cannot live there without special habitats. Without special habitats, we cannot live in space either. Yet, from the ocean of space, the stars call to us, with the tantalizing promise of planets to explore. We don't know exactly where the first life on Earth formed. We just know that it did. Perhaps it was near a volcanic vent on the primordial ocean floor, or in an ancient tidal pool warmed by the sun. Wherever it happened, life began in single-celled isolation and flourished. From tiny microbes to multicellular splendor, life spread throughout the sea. Here, volcanic vents send superheated jets of mineral-rich water into the murky cold of the ocean bottom. With the geographical discovery of these vents came a biological surprise: life. Thriving colonies of clams, shrimp, and worms cluster around the chimney-like structures. They live in darkness, under immense water pressure. If it got that chance here, is it possible life got the chance somewhere else in the universe? Are there other planets with water, warmth, and organic materials? These questions drive our search for extraterrestrial life. But the Mars we see today shows no signs of life on its surface. Somehow, something happened to ancient Mars, and whatever life that may have existed disappeared. Peering into the dust and gas of the Orion molecular cloud, the Hubble Space Telescope has imaged the birthplaces of stars, and possibly the beginnings of planetary systems around them. Nestled within the gas clouds are disc-shaped condensations of dusty material, some twice the size of our solar system. They surround newly forming stars, hidden in their central cores. How many other suns are there, with planets of their own? We honestly don't know. But we can imagine a myriad of watery blue planets throughout the galaxy, awaiting explorers to find them, to search for life beneath the waves of other oceans in space.